Photography is the only language that can be understood anywhere in the world. Today, I turn my lens closer to my own surroundings. Join me in my quest for the perfect shot in the wild with the EOS 200D Mark II and EFS 55-250 lens. Hello, I'm Aishwarya Sridhar, a wildlife filmmaker and photographer, and also a Canon EOS influencer. Now, an integral part of wildlife photography is bird photography. And the wetlands in and around Mumbai are a perfect place to capture action when it comes to birds. I am at the Talave wetlands near Navi Mumbai to photograph the flamboyant flamingos who have come here in super large numbers. I've spotted a mixture of juvenile and adult lesser flamingos. Some of them are roosting and some are feeding. It's time for some nice behavior shots. When it comes to bird photography, it's good to use a telephoto lens like the 55-250 EFS lens that I am using along with the 200D Mark II. Now, a telephoto zoom lens allows you to capture a mixture of both close-up shots as well as those beautiful in-habitat shots. Let's take some videos as well.
The 200D Mark II shoots amazing 4K videos with superb clarity, just what I need to film these pink beauties.
Let's try and get closer to the flamingos.
The camera is so light, it allows you to be super mobile.
The muddy waters in the front add a beautiful foreground to the entire frame. Now this allows you to add depth. So adding a little bit of foreground elements always works well while clicking birds. There is an egret very close to me. Now the tricky part when it comes to shooting white birds is that you tend to overexpose them. So the trick is you underexpose the shot and then you take the image. By that way, you expose the whites in your frame perfectly. A few flamingos have just landed quite close. Let's go there.
The guided display and the high-speed continuous shooting help me get the perfect shot.
The tide is going out, which means that the flamingos will leave for the creek very soon. So I'm really waiting for them to fly so that I can get those superb flight shots. So when you're capturing birds in action, you can look for telltale signs. You need to anticipate action first of all. Like for example, wing flaps or increased alertness, movement, a raised head. So you look for these and then you anticipate their flight and then you frame your shot.
So to get amazing shots of birds, here are a few things to keep in mind. Include a little bit of the foreground element to tell a story. It's not always about close-ups, but the habitat can play a really good role in enhancing your image. Observe the bird and try to anticipate its movement to get those super fly shots. I know it's not easy and it would definitely come with practice. And when you have a really bright bird like an egret, which is completely white, then underexpose the bird to capture the white colors perfectly.
That's it for today. Happy clicking!